Hey you guys, welcome to my April favorites video. It's gonna be May. Okay, cool. Yay, May. I love May. May is Mother's Day. May is my son's birthday. So May is great. But May is always so busy. Why is that? And we're never out of town for Memorial Day weekend or anything like that. We are just always busy in May. All right. April was interesting. Did it feel short because there was only 30 days? Because there was spring break in there? I don't know. I also feel like normally I have so many products to pick from and whittle down and be like, oh, what am I going to choose? And this month it was kind of like, huh, here we go. I just feel like I have a short little, a small little selection. But let's start with some sort of random items. This is the Avanti Smile Teeth Whitening. I put it back in the package so it would look nice for you. Otherwise, it's just this, you know, like tray for my toothpaste. Anyway, well, actually it's this prep gel. And I did a video on this. It's the Glow in the Dark Teeth Whitening. And it really works. I really like it. I actually need to do it again. I mean, they look okay, but I do need to do it again. You can do it as many times as you want. It does not make your teeth feel sensitive at all. And I have a coupon code, so I will list that below. The coupon code is only good for like another week or so. It expires in May, so keep that in mind. Also, I got the Clarisonic makeup brush head. And you guys saw that video, hopefully. Why can't I? Here, I'm just gonna. I use it on my Clarisonic Uplift, which they sent me the new Smart Uplift. And then I went ahead and I ordered the brush head. You can get it on Ulta and you can get it on the Clarisonic website. And I'm not sure if you can get it at Sephora yet or anything like that. I'll look and then I'll list below where you can get it. You know, when I originally did that video, by the way, it went on really thick, and some of you were like, wow, awesome, and some of you are like, holy no. And I get it. I totally get it, because that first batch of liquid and product, when you put it on your face, it is kind of thick. But what I love about this is that you can blend. And like, it just does such a good job blending your neck, and it makes everything so seamless. Right here, I always get like problems blending, so still tickles my nose. Here's the thing. I said, oh, you have to replace these and blah, blah, blah. You don't have to replace this. Why would you have to replace it? Maybe you do, maybe after a while, but I mean, you don't replace your brushes and you use those all the time. You just wash them. And I've already washed it and it's really easy. And I'm thinking you do have to replace a beauty blender though frequently. So maybe it is more cost effective. I don't know. But if you already have a Clarisonic or a Mia, and you want to try the brush head, I would. If you haven't invested in a Clarisonic yet, then go ahead and watch my videos on them, and yeah, I think you'll be happy. Okay, so speaking of foundation, I am wearing my LA Girl Pro HD. I really like this stuff. I'm wearing the shade Porcelain, and I did a Bargain of the Week foundation featured kind of combined video, because this is $7 or $8 and it works so good, and there's a pretty good shade range. But I will say though that the colors, this is their lightest. I think this is their lightest, and I feel like it's good for me, but if you are very Porcelain, it might not work for you. And I don't know how well they are for dark skins, but I do love this foundation. It's such a good product for the value. And on top of that, I have been loving my CoverGirl, which you guys saw in my Bargain of the Week. Last week I did the concealer and this powder, and I think I put the concealer in a previous month's favorite, so it's still my favorite. I still use it every day. You guys were telling me how you set your under eye concealer with the Advanced Radiance powder, or you were asking me what's the difference. And for me, this Outlast powder works better than the Radiance. The Radiance is nice on my skin, but does not work under my eyes. This works better everywhere. And I think it's whatever the Dimethicone or whatever the Outlast technology is in there is what keeps it flexible on the skin so it doesn't get into any creases, which always kind of scares me. But yeah, so this powder is very nice, but I prefer the Outlast. So there is my verdict. There's my, like, because you guys were asking. And also, so I included my Marcel face powder because this stuff is so good and I've been using it ever since the summer, but I sort of don't, I'm not as loyal to it as maybe I should be. And then I did that loose powder video and then I was like, okay, and now I have this on hand all the time. Of course, I also have my YSL powder. Okay, yeah, the Marcel face powder, it is a large quantity for less than $20. And you can get it on the Birchbox site. It's just a very basic face powder that I think is good for everything and every skin type, and I like it. And also face powder, Color Science. You guys, they sent me this. So this is their mineral sunscreen. It's portable, it's SPF 50. Remember that sunscreen wears down on the face every couple hours, so if you are outside all day and you've only put your sunscreen on once, you are getting UVA rays. And UVA rays is 90% of what ages us. So even if you're not getting burnt outside, you are getting aged. This is shade medium. I thought these were refillable, but I haven't figured that out yet. But this is shade medium. Somebody asked, like, how do you know you're putting it on? You know you're putting it on. You can see the little bit of powder. You can also kind of see it on your skin, but it doesn't leave. For me, I wouldn't use this as makeup. I would use it just as sunscreen. You can use it by itself, or you can use it as a touch-up over your regular sunscreen. But I feel like it's just, as we head into the warmer, longer days, that you really, I have one in my purse, and you just should protect yourself. And it does not interfere with your makeup, which I think is the reason I've never reapplied sunscreen during the day. And maybe that is why I have pigmentation and crepey eyelids and stuff. You know, it's like, oh my God, had I known this 10 years ago, I would have been putting it on. And I have a hair. You guys always find that funny when I have a hair stuck to my lip somewhere. Can't tell if it's makeup brush hair or cat hair. Love this Vera Mona sponge. It's the cake and bake sponge. And I put on my concealer with it. I put on powder with it. I really like it. I think I like it for the edge. I think that's what it is. You can get it on the Sephora website now. It is under the Sephora collection. This is the same as the Vera Mona namesake on the Camera Ready Cosmetics website. So it just, whichever website you happen to be shopping on, just know they're the same thing and I love it. And I love my Hoola powder. Did I put this in last month's favorites? Okay, I don't know if I did, but anyway, I love it. I keep looking for a dupe, but I think what I love about this powder is that I feel like I don't go overboard with bronzing, because sometimes I do that and I get a little orange. And also, it's soft. It just has such a nice soft finish on the skin. And it doesn't, you know, look muddy or break down or anything like that. It's just a really good quality product. Kind of ticks me off because I'm looking for a dupe. The Wet n Wild is great. The Essence is great, but there's still, this one edges them out, in my opinion. So, wow, I don't have a lipstick. No, I have a lip pencil. The Kat Von D Everlasting Lip Pencil. Not sure why I'm falling in love with this, because maybe it's very similar to other drugstore pencils I've had, but I'm a sucker for a retractable pencil. I love Kat Von D and her products. The Everlasting Liquid Lip is awesome, and so to have a liner that lasts as long and wears as well, I think is so great. What I love about this is it goes on so soft, but then it sets and it's like forever, you know? So you could probably fill in your lip a little bit and then put your lipstick on so that when you're eating, you don't have the, you know, especially if you're eating like oily food. Don't you love that? And you're just like left with lip liner. Okay, this is Bow and Arrow, and it is, in my opinion, the perfect nude lip. And I think, no, it doesn't. I was gonna say, and it has a sharpener. No, it doesn't. So, I even got I got the Lolita. I think I got the Lolita. Did I get the Lolita or the OG Lolita? I got another one. So, yeah. Cover FX setting spray is like so great. What is the... So I think this is more expensive ounce per ounce than the MAC Fix Plus, which then what's the point? But this is really good. It's really good. You know what I'm saying? No, it is alcohol free, which you guys, sensitive skin, I need an alcohol free formula. And there's several out there that are alcohol free, but then there's some that aren't. And so you're like, ooh, is this a good setting spray? And then it's got alcohol in it. And I just got the Kat Von D Locket setting spray in my VIB Rouge sale order, and it hasn't come yet. And I'm wondering if that has alcohol in it, because I didn't check. So anyway, the nice thing about the Cover FX spray is the sprayer is really good. It has kind of this, like when you push it down, it kind of goes for a long time and then it just kind of, you know, mists it out. So aerosol, you know how you love aerosol hairspray because you can kind of go and yet you're like, sorry, it's aerosol. But this is like that. Like it has just such a nice spray. It's great for illuminating. It's great for setting. It's Cover FX. It's really good. So yeah, I think it's $30. So anyway, yeah, made in Canada. Go Canada, we love you. Okay, I think that's everything. Yes, so May, I'm ready for ya. So I hope you guys enjoyed my favorites. Let me know what your favorites were for the month of April. And click that thumbs up button. Subscribe. By the way, this little Froogi little watermark, that's a subscribe button if you didn't know it. So you can click on, is it on this side or this side? I don't know. I'll have to see when I'm filming, when I'm editing, if I'm flipped. Anyway, okay. I will see you guys next video. Thanks so much. Bye.